Hey everyone, it's your buddy Graphic back with another video, and today we're going to be jumping into an Outpost Rush gameplay. If you guys have not seen Outpost Rush, there's a lot to really go into detail about, so we're not going to talk about any of it before we get started. We're going to kind of show you everything in detail. Like I said, there's a lot of great ways to actually take advantage of this game type, as you see that the main goal is to reach 1,000 points to win. So there's going to be three different really points on the map. There's going to be the moon, the star, and the middle point, which is going to be the sun. So the first thing we're going to have is a couple people going over to the star to hold that point, and then we're going to have some people go over to the actual sun in the middle of the map. That point is going to be the one that a lot of people have, you know, most of their fights taking place. Obviously, there are back caps where you'll try to sneak around, flank, and grab their point as well, but here I'm using my honing stone and taking advantage of all the pots, hopefully, in my inventory as well. But, you know, there's going to be a lot of, like I said, great fights in PvP in this mode. And you'll also, by the way, at the end of the actual at the end of the Outpost Rush, you'll get a reward based on if you won or lost. And I believe I've only won so far. I'm thinking I'm 3-0 in Outpost Rush. It was fun every single time. But this was my actual first Outpost Rush, so I thought this would be the most relevant for you guys, as it was a really close and long battle. But the cool thing is, like I said, there is a Baroness on the side. So you can see that the Baroness on the top right says the really appears in, what was it, 8 minutes? Yeah, 8 minutes, 48 seconds. So if somebody gets that, if our team or their team last hits it, then guess what? Well, that team that got it will actually put the opponent's team in a point where they actually don't earn points. So their points will actually be paused. And obviously that does not help when you're trying to reach 1,000 points as fast as you can. So here we're going to start off with a Fire Staff. Obviously great damage and really a great build for Outpost Rush, because you're going to have so much mobility, you're going to have so much AoE damage, and they have a great start to this game. They have both points kind of secured. They're taking advantage of middle right now. I'm trying to push through, get some damage down, but, you know, heals are so strong in Outpost Rush specifically. You can see that I am getting to the back lines now, trying to take advantage, but then we have an Ice Gauntlet. Hoping he pops out, I do a post. Nothing there, but, you know, I'm not going to talk through the entire gameplay. I definitely could, and if you guys want to see something like that, maybe I should, but, you know, right now I just wanted to kind of give you an update on how Outpost Rush kind of works. And like I said, if you get a win, you'll actually get up to like 315 gold, I believe. So that's what I got every single time. So I got about 1,000 gold in just 3 matches of Outpost Rush, and I believe you get about 400 Azoth as well. So it fills up your Azoth bar, fills up your gold very quickly, which is good, because, you know, you use a lot of potions in you know, Outpost Rush, definitely if you're going in hot. So, you know, if you're burning all those potions, you're probably gonna need some gold to, you know, buy them back at the very least if you don't have your Arcana up. So thank you guys again for tuning in. I'm gonna let you, like I said, see this entire gameplay. We do end up winning, but you can see now that it's going to be a very close game, with us already starting with a kind of rough situation here, rough start. You know, there's a lot of cool aspects to Outpost Rush. I think this game mode is going to continue to make a lot of people happy about it, you know, because it's a way to really get some great PvP right off the bat, where they're not just people running away the whole time. There's not just people running, you know, into you, into a, you know, a 10v5. This is an even 20v20 matchup with a lot of cool aspects to it, not just gathering and crafting this time, or sorry, not just the regular PvP this time around, but you actually, like I said, you get kind of gathering and crafting as well in this mode if you really want to take advantage of it. You know, I am kind of starting to stumble with my words just a little bit. We had a crazy night of grinding here. Like I said, 3 Outpost Rushes. We did 2 Garden of Genesis dungeons and, you know, a little bit more of Murk Guard in the top of the Shattered Mountain Zone. So I'm going to call it a night, but if you guys want, like I said, to continue to watch this gameplay, it was a lot of fun playing this game. So I'll leave you with the gameplay footage itself if you guys want to learn a little bit more about Outpost Rush and how it works, and my Rapier Fire Staff build, and see how it competed, like I said, with some of these other builds. Make sure to do so. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, turn notifications on. I'll see you guys all in the next one.
Thank you. Please, no! Yeah.